Hi, in this video, we are going to talk about how to create a list of prime numbers, list and or equal to a number in Python programming language. For example, here is a list of prime numbers, list and or equal to 150. First of all, consider a simpler example. Suppose that we want to specify whether this number is prime or not. But here is a question. What is the characteristic of a prime number? Yes, that's true. It's only divisible by 1 and the number itself. So it is just only divisible by 1 and the number itself. So as you can see, a prime number is not divisible to any other numbers between these two bounds. I mean, this lower bound and this upper bound. So a prime number is not divisible to any other numbers between these two bounds. But for example, suppose another example. Suppose that a number is equal to 9. As you can see, 9 is also divisible to 3, which is a number between these two bounds. So it is not a prime number. And also consider another example. For example, let's suppose 15, which is again divisible to 5, 3. And as you can see, it is not a prime number. So in order to check whether a number is prime or not, we should check whether it is divisible to any number between these two bounds. So let's start coding. First, we define a variable called isPrime and we assign true to this variable. It means that at first, we suppose the number is prime. So now we should check whether the number is divisible to any other number between these two bounds. When I say between these two bounds, I mean to all the way up to number minus 1. So here we should simply type for I in range of, for I in range of 2 and number. And remember that we shouldn't write number minus 1. We should write number. Why? Because in the range function in Python programming language, number, I mean the second value, is exclusive. So we should write number in order to consider number minus 1. So there it is. So now we want to check whether this number is divisible to any of these values. So we simply type if the number is divisible to I. And as you can see, for saying that this is divisible to I, we simply type if the remainder of the division is equal to 0, which means they are divisible, then it's very obvious that the number is not prime. So we are going to assign false to the isPrime variable. And because we have found a number between these two bounds that the number is divisible to, we can see that the number is not prime. So we are not going to check other numbers. So we are breaking the for because we know that the number is not prime. So we are not going to check other numbers. So after all, if we print isPrime, and if I run the code, you can see 15 is not prime. But for example, if we pass 5 and if I run the code again, you can see the number is prime. And also for the sake of effectiveness, we don't need to check whether this number is divisible to the numbers between these two bounds. I mean, to all the way up to number minus 1. We just need to check whether this number is divisible to 2 all the way up to the square root of the number. So here we should change this number to the power of 0.5. And also remember that this is a float number. So we should convert it to integer. We should convert it to an integer. And remember that in the range function of Python programming language, this value is exclusive. But if you want to include this value, you should type +1 in order to include this value. So now if I run the code, you can see it works properly. And for example, another example, and if I run the code again, you can see it works totally fine. And let's remove these lines. And now let's explain why we have used the square root of the number. So let's explain it. As you know, the prime number is only divisible to 1 and the number itself. But if we find any factors between these two values, so if we find any factors like a and b, which they are going to multiply each other and result n, then we say the number is not prime. So let's suppose that a is less than or equal to b. And as you can see, this is a general case, not a specific case. We are saying we have two numbers, a and b, which a is less than or equal to b. And if we write it again, a less than or equal to b. And now let's multiply this one by a. So we simply get a2 less than or equal to ab. And again, let's multiply this by b. So we simply get ab less than or equal to b2. But as you can see, ab is equal to n. So it says that a2 is less than or equal to n, and also n is less than or equal to b2. And from these two, we can say n is greater than a2 and less than or equal to b2. And if we take the square root of these numbers, so we will have the square root of n greater than or equal to the absolute value of a and less than or equal to the absolute value of b. But as you can see, a and b is greater than 1, which is positive, which means they are positive. So the absolute value of a and b is going to be a and b respectively. So now it's very obvious that if we want to find a factor, we just need to search for the numbers from 2 all the way up to the square root of the number, not any further. So by far we have checked whether this number is prime or not, but maybe we want to create a list of prime numbers, for example, a list of prime numbers less than or equal to 100. So in order to do so, we simply cut these lines and we simply type for number in range of 2 all the way up to, why 2? Because the smallest prime number is 2. So we are simply type for number in range of 2 all the way up to 100 and plus 1. And this plus 1 is because this is exclusive. And if we want to include it, we should write plus 1. There it is. And we paste these lines. And I should delete this line. And here, we want to create a list, which is, let's say, prime list. And if the number, if the number is prime, if is prime is equal to true, I mean the number is prime, then we are going to add the number to prime list. So we are going to say prime list that append the number. So after all, if we print the prime list, and if I run the code, you can see this is the prime list of numbers less than or equal to 100. And if you want, you can go further, and for example, maybe you want to define a function. Maybe you want to define a function, let's say called prime, which gets a value, an argument called n, which the function is going to return a list of prime numbers less than or equal to n. So we paste the code and we change this 100 to n because you want to return all the prime numbers less than or equal to n. And also here we should return the prime list. So now we want to, for example, return a list of prime numbers less than or equal to 150. So if I run the code, you can see these are the prime numbers less than or equal to 150.